Today we are going to study experiment number 2 of power system operation control. The title of the experiment is to apply equal area criteria for stability analysis under fault condition. For this experiment we will require MATLAB Simulink software. Before we go in detail of the programming, we will study the theory behind the experiment. We will study the application of equal area criteria, that is sudden short circuit on one of parallel line, in which we will study the case number 2, that is short circuit away from line end, that means the short circuit occurs at midpoint of the one of the transmission line. For that we will assume one generator which is connected to an infinite bus bar through two transmission lines. Here we will assume the mechanical power input to the generator is constant, and initially the generator is operating at initial power angle delta 0. When the fault occurs, the power flow through the transmission line is not equal to 0, and after fault is cleared or circuit breakers operated, the faulted line is isolated from the system and power flow is again restored through the healthy line. So the single line diagram of the system is given by this figure. So, figure shows the single line diagram. Under this condition, the electrical power flow from the generator to the infinite bus is given by P1 is equals to E dash into V upon XD dash upon plus XL1 in parallel with XL2. This is electrical power 1 before fault condition. Now, we will study during fault condition by using the power angle curve. This is the power angle curve before fault occurs. When mechanical power is constant, as we assume that mechanical power we will not change, this mechanical power we will not change in the operation. So mechanical power is constant for all over the operation. So the initial operating point is plotted or identified with the help of mechanical power. So A is the initial operating point. When fault occurs in one of the transmission line, here the fault occurs, when fault occurs, three phase fault occurs in one of the transmission line, the power flow will be reduced and the point of operation will shift from A to B, and the power angle curve will be given by this second curve. Now when we observe the power angle curve at point B, where mechanical power is greater than electrical power, so rotor will start accelerating and it will store the energy in the machine, during which the power angle will be increasing from delta 0 to delta C, where the fault clears or circuit breakers operated. Now we assume this circuit breakers operates at point C like this. Just observe here, this circuit breakers 2 and 4 are operating and power angle curve shifts from C to E. New power angle curve is given by this third curve. So point of operation now shifts from C to E. When the delta increases from delta 0 to delta C, the machine stores the kinetic energy and the area is given by area 1. This stored kinetic energy must be given back. So for that purpose, the power angle increases from delta C to delta 2, during which the stored kinetic energy is given out. So this P1 is the before fault curve, P2, P3 is the after fault curve. This is area 1, this is area 2, and this is curve 2. So here you can observe area 1 must be equal to area 2 under fault condition, then only the machine under consideration will remain in the synchronism. So P2 power angle equation for curve 2 is given by E dash into V upon x2 sin delta here the transfer reactance x2 we have to find out, and p3 is equals to e dash v upon xd dash plus xl1. For p3 curve or p3 condition, after fault condition, the transfer reactance is very easily find out like this. So xd dash in addition with xl1, we will get the transfer reactance for p3. In case of p2, we have to find out this x2. So how to find out the x2? We will see with the help of one numerical. So the statement of the numerical is given as a 60 hertz synchronous generator having inertia constant h is equals to 5 mega joule per MVA and direct axis transient reactance xd dash is equals to 0.3 per unit is connected to an infinite bus through a purely reactive circuit as shown in the figure. Reactants are marked on the diagram on a purely on common system base. The generator is delivering real power. P is equals to 0.8 per unit and Q is equals to 0.074 per unit to the infinite bus at a voltage of V is equals to 1 per unit. A three-phase fault occurs at middle of the one of the line. The fault is cleared and the faulted line is isolated. Determine the critical clearing angle. So here you should understand or you should concentrate on this particular sentence where the statement gives us or statement tells us that the fault occurs at midpoint of the one of the line and it is cleared. After some time it is cleared and faulted line is isolated. So we have to consider the analysis that we have already seen in this session. So in this numerical, xd dash is given, electrical power, active power P is given, reactive power is given, voltage is given. So with respect to this data, we will start with our analysis. Before that, we will draw the single line diagram. Single line diagram will start from generator whose angle E dash, whose voltage, internal voltage E dash angle delta is not given in the numerical. So this voltage we have to find out, E dash into angle delta, which is not is given in the numerical statement of the numerical. This generator is connected through internal reactance xd dash, which is given in the numerical. Then one transformer is there. So transformers per unit reactance, that is 0.2, it is given. Then two transmission lines whose reactances are given. Then these transmission lines are connected to the infinite bus bar whose voltage is also given in the numerical. And single three phase fault occurs at one of the transmission line as shown in the figure. The three phase fault occurs at this point. As in this case, the mechanical power is not changed and the load connected at infinite bus is also not changed. So electrical power, which is given in the statement of the numerical PE, will be same as PM. That means we can say that the mechanical power supplied to generator is converted into electrical power, totally converted into electrical power. So PM is equals to PE is equals to 0.8 per unit. So we will divide this numerical into three sections before fault occurs. In this case, the system is look like this, single line diagram is look like this. So as I have stated that the E dash is not given in the numerical. So we will start with E dash. We will first find out E dash. So the voltage equation of generator E dash is given by E dash is equals to V plus J X 12 into I. So here V is given, V is present. X12 is not present and I is not present. So first we will find out X12, that is transfer reactance. Transfer reactance is very simple. In this case, this is the single line diagram. So just add these two reactances, XD dash, XT, and take the parallel combination of XL1 and XL2. So transfer reactance, we can call X1 because this is step number one. So we can also call X1. So XD dash plus XT plus XL1 in parallel with XL2. It is x1 is equals to 0.65 per unit. So you have to remember this value, x1 is equals to 0.65 per unit. then we will find out current I as it is not present. So for that purpose we will start with complex power delivered by generator. It's given by S is equals to V into I asterisk. So this star is nothing but the complex conjugate of current. When we write in terms of current I, the equation becomes S star upon V star. So put the value of S. S is given as P is equals to 0.8 per unit and Q is equal to 0.074. So S is equal to 0.8 plus J 0.074 per unit. So we will put these values into this equation. I, we can write I is equals to 0.8 minus 0.074 J per unit. So when we write the value of current and value of transfer reactance into first equation, we can write E dash is equals to 1.0 plus 0.65 J into 0.8 minus 0.074 J. The value of E is given by 1.17 angle 26.387 per unit. So this is the value of E dash. Here the angle with respect to E dash is nothing but the initial power angle delta 0. So here at this step only we can find out the delta 0. Similar way, or we can find out the delta 0 by this way also. So write PE1 is equals to E dash V upon X12 sine delta. Write all the values in the equation. So P1 is equals to 1.8 sine delta. So P1 max is equals to 1.8 per unit. When we write P1 is equals to 0.8 as P1 in the numerical is given as 0.8. So here 0.8 is equals to 1.8 sine delta 0. So delta 0 will become 26.38, or in radian it is 0.46055 radians. So same value we have observed. So at this step only you can find out the delta 0, or using this particular method you also find out the delta 0. Now during fault, second step during fault. So fault is occur at this point. So during fault, the power flow, electrical power flow is not equal to 0. So some power is transferring from generator to infinite bus. So we will find out the circuit, single line diagram, equivalent circuit during the fault. So take the addition of xd dash and xt. So xd dash plus xt is equals to 0.3 plus 0.2. The two reactances in parallel combination like this. Fault occurs at one of the line. Complete the circuit. This is the circuit. So modify this circuit. So generator, infinite bus, one reactance 0.5. The summation of two reactances xd dash and xt 0.5, one transmission line xl1, and one reactance, that is second transmission line reactance, is divided by the fault like this way. Complete the circuit. So here you can observe the star connection in between these three reactances. So convert this star into delta so that you can find out the transfer reactance between generator and infinite bus. So we will just write the star connection, put the numbers on star connections, find out the delta connection. So this is x12, this is x13, this is x23. So find out the delta. X12 is equals to 1.8 per unit. Similarly, you can find out X13 and X23. We put the delta connection into the circuit and we redraw the circuit like this. So here you can observe Here you can observe the transfer reactance is given by transfer reactance in between the generator and infinite bus is given by X12 is equals to 1.8 per unit. So P2 is equals to E dash V upon transfer reactance sine delta, P2 max sine delta 1.17 up into 1 upon 1.8 sine delta. That means P2 max is equals to 0.65 per unit. Now the last step after fault analysis. As we have assumed at the start that when fault is cleared or the circuit breakers are operated, the faulted section is isolated and the power is stored through the healthy section. So the circuit will be look like this. So power will be restored like this to the infinite bus. This faulted section is isolated. This faulted section is isolated from the system. So transfer reactance is given by X3 is equal to XD dash plus XT plus XL1, that is 0.8. P3 is equal to E dash V upon transfer reactance sine delta, P3 max sine delta. That means P3 is equal to 1.17 into 1 upon 0.8 sine delta. P3 max is equal to 1.462 per unit. 1.462 per unit. Now delta max is equal to 180 degree minus delta 0. Here we will find out the delta max for case 3. If you observe the power angle curve for this particular example, you can see here the delta max is with respect to curve 3, delta 0 is it with respect to curve 1. Delta 0, just observe, delta 0 is with respect to curve 1, delta max is with respect to curve 3. So we have to find out the delta 0 to find out the delta max with respect to curve 3 only. That is means, if you clearly see here, the D point gives the delta 0 value with respect to curve 3. So this delta 0 we have to put here so that you can find out the delta max. So to find out delta 0, you have to write the equation. Delta 0 is equal to sine inverse of Pm upon P3 max. Here just observe, I have written here P3 max. So P3 max is equal to 1.462. So delta 0 is equal to 33.17. initially delta 0 was 26 degree with respect to curve 1, but after fault clears, the curve is P3. So with respect to P3, the delta 0 is 33.17 degree. So delta max is 146.83 degree or 2.5628 radian. Now assume the critical clearing angle. Formula for critical clearing angle is given by Pm into bracket delta max minus delta 0 bracket complete minus P2 max cos delta 0 plus P3 max cos delta max. It is upon P3 max minus P2 max. Put all the values that we have already calculated till step. So in this equation, so we can write cos delta C is equals to minus 0.15356. So delta C is equals to 98.83 degree. This is the critical clearing angle. So for this particular numerical, we will write the MATLAB program, and we will verify the values with the help of MATLAB simulink program. Percentage to apply equal area criteria for stability analysis under fault, percentage condition using MATLAB simulink software. Here you just observe that I have write the percentage in front of the statement. So this percentage, when you write percentage in some in front of some statement, the particular statement will not be executed, or it will be skipped by the MATLAB while the execution of the program. So you can write such type of statement in the program so that you can understood what actually you have done in that program. So this is just an example for your understanding. You can write anywhere in the program, or whatever you have to write, you just write down. Now whatever the parameters that we have already calculated or we have already given in the statement of the numerical, these parameters we will take from the keyboard. So first parameter is PM, that is mechanical power input. So with the help of input function, we will take from the keyword. So input function, how it is work? When you write input in small letter, in bracket, single inverted comma, the description of the variable, then variable is equals to single inverted comma complete, bracket complete, semicolon. So in this way, the variable will be taken from the keyboard. Similar way, you can take e, then v, then x1, x2 and x3. These are the variables we will take directly from the keyboard, as these variables we have calculated e, v, x1, x2 and x3. Next, calculate p1 max is equals to ev upon x1, p2 max is equals to ev upon x2, p3 max is equals to ev upon x3. Then find out delta 0 with respect to curve 1. So here you have to remember, or you have to carefully write the equation, delta 0 is equals to p1 max in the MATLAB program. Then find out delta max. Here just observe, here I have written p3 max. Carefully you have to remember these two things. If you mistake these two things or make confusion in these two things, then it will be wrong one. Then write the formula for cos delta c. Then cos delta c, then you will get the value of delta c by taking the inverse of the cos. So for inverse, you have to write only a in front of the trigonometry function. Here trigonometry function is cos, you just write a so that it will calculate the inverse. Then the angles which we have calculated earlier, that is delta 0, delta max and delta c, which are calculated in terms of radian, you just convert into degrees. So for that purpose, you will require to multiply 180 and divide by pi. Then printf function, whatever the parameters you want to print, you just write for printf function. I will just print initial power angle, then maximum angle swing, then critical clearing angle. So initial power angle, how this particular function is work. So printf in small letter, single bracket, single inverted comma, slash n, initial power angle. Whatever the description of the output you have to write, you just write down description, then is equal to, then percent f, then slash n delta 0. Similar way, delta max and delta c. So in output, generator output power in per unit PM will be equals to 0.8, generator EMF in per unit E is equals to 1.7, infinite bus bar voltage V is equals to 1, reactance before fault X1 is equal to 0.65, X2 is equals to 1.8, X3 is equals to 0.8. When you write all these values through the keyboard, then output will be initial power angle 26.38 degree, maximum angle swing 146.83 degree, critical clearing angle 98.83 degree. So this is the output of our program. So this particular program we will run in the MATLAB. So this is the program, same program I have written here in the MATLAB Simulink software. So here you can see PM is equals to input, generator output power in per unit, E is equals to input, V is equals to input, similar way X1, X2, X3. For all five parameters, we have input, or we have taken from the keyboard using the input function. Then we have calculated P1 max, P2 max, P3 max, then we have calculated delta 0 and delta max. Just see here, while calculating delta 0, we have put here P1 max, and while calculating delta max, we have written here P3 max. Then we have written the formula for cos delta, for critical clearing angle, as it is formula we have written here. But while you just remember that while writing the formula, you have to remember the variables which you have defined earlier. That means Pm, E, V, X1, X2, X3, P1 max, P2 max, P3 max. As it is variable, you have to return in the formula. Do not change from capital to small, small to capital letters. Then find out delta C. Then convert all these angles into degree by multiplying 180 by pi. Then printf function. Then printf function. After printf function, these three will be displayed on the MATLAB home screen. Once again, we will. So I have run the program. So when you open the MATLAB, you will see such type of display in the home screen. So here in the left corner, it is current folder. So where the last program is saved, it is shown in here. In the middle one, there is command window. If you input some command, that means I just write capital I is equals to 1. So capital I will be executed, I is equals to 1. And you just see when I have executed I is equals to 1, here the variable is stored in the workspace. So whenever the variables are executed or whenever the program is executed, the variables is automatically stored in the workspace of the window. So workspace contains all the variables of the program. So what is the use of workspace? So with the help of workspace, you can identify what are the variables and what is the value of these variables. So when sometime what happens, the program is of multiple pages. In that case, the identification of the variables will become very difficult task. So just go in the workspace and find out the variables and its value. Similarly, command history shows the last command run or executed. So I have executed here I is equals to 1. So it will show here in the command history. Now I have to clear the command window. So you just write clc. Suppose I have to clear the workspace. How to write workspace? Clear all, right? Command clear all. Once again, I will run the program. So generator output power in per unit is given by 0.8 1 point. Generator input EMF input in per unit is 1.17, phi is 1.65, x2 is equals to 0.8. So this is the output. This is the output of the program. Here you can see I have cleared all the workspace, but after the execution of the program, the workspace is again filled with the variables. When you enter, now you command, you do some command. So I will write here capital E and enter. E will be equals to 1.17. As the variable is defined earlier, E is equals to 1.17. If you define here E is equals to, capital E is equals to 1, the variable's value, you just observe E is equals to 1.17, it will get changed to 1. Just see E is equals to 1. So now when program will be executed once again, value of E will be 1. So this particular program you can write in different way also. Here this is very basic program, so to understand the MATLAB. So you can write this program with the help of different types of loops, like while loop, for loop, if loop, and some different logics you can apply to understand the MATLAB and the system which is under fault condition. I hope you understood the experiment. Thank you for watching.